Mate, I'm Biff, and I'm playing Ultima Online on the server Outlands. The build for today is full credit to Antoine, who challenged me to play this Dexa Trapper instead of my usual Summoner Bard Trapper. And I gotta say, this build is super fun and super tanky. If you like playing something different, something off-meta, then this build might be good for you, and you can use it to solo the M4 room, which is pretty awesome. So, shout out again to Antoine for showing me that you don't need an Earth Elemental to tank and trap, that you can just use your face instead. I'll go through the template now, including codex, aspect, chain links, equipment loadout, and hotkeys. And then after this, I'll take you through M4 and explain how to play the build with some of the key mechanics. First off, here's everything on screen that you need, so you can take a screenshot now. But starting with the template, Tinkering and Detect Hidden. These are our trap skills for damage and cooldown reduction. We got Wrestling and Tactics at 80, just so we can obtain the crab stance. We are not interested in damage here at all. We got Parry 80, so we can gain access to Bulwark in the Codex, with Last Stand as the finisher. Healing and Anatomy is self-explanatory, and the leftover points go into Camping for Carry Weight and a little Alchemy. For aspect, we go gadget. Each time you use a trap, you gain a 10-second resist buff, which is absolutely clutch for this build's survival. We aren't too enthusiastic about the weapon proc, since majority of the time our character is paralyzed while placing, but we are punching between traps, and the added damage is nice when it does proc. You might as well bring weapon oil to enhance this, since the cores are cheap anyway within the current market. For wrestling codex, we want crab stance. I never switch away from this, it's our core survival. And again, we are not interested in damage here. Parry Codex, again, Bulwark and Last Stand. Bulwark requires us to remain stationary, which I guess synergizes with the seizure your character will have every time you place a trap anyway. The trap kit as follows. Killswitch is our main bread and butter for damage. Since we are an M4, the mobs that we're fighting have a high HP, so getting free extra traps is really nice, and I've often found that can chain after consecutive traps. Like sometimes I've had 4 trap resets in a row, which is really satisfying. For chain links, your first 10 I recommend trap damage links, followed by 10 mausoleum links, with the last 10 being damage by player links. Some people like the 66% life and the 33% life to damage links, but I'm not sold on the idea just yet. For your loadout, I'll just put that on the screen now, take a screenshot. Lastly, let's go over keybinds. key for placing traps with another key to detonate traps, a key to target closest enemy monster, a key to attack last target, a key to bandage, keys for each potion, including the cleansing brew, a key to rope, a key to activate Bepeth's item recycler, a key to detect hidden in case of nearby thieves or stealth PKs. But be nice to the dungeon pickers, please. So we can begin here, see the intro on how to skip to this location. And we basically want to rope to this tile so we can skip the patrician to the south. The idea is to get a punch in first to gain access to Crab Stance. Even a miss will do the trick. Then we lay the trap, detonate it, giving us the gadget resist buff. The third layer of protection is Bulwark from Parody, which we will maintain by staying completely stationary. These three things are the key essentials to what makes this build tanky. Once the Manticore is down, just remain stationary and wait for the blast. This bug can be a huge pain in the ass, because sometimes the disease can stack like 5 times and kill you shortly after you've killed it. So the key is to remain stationary, keep bandaging, chugging pots, and then make the call if you need to use a cleansing brew, and sometimes you won't need to, just like in this case. The archer is also a mega pain in the butt. My method is to lay a trap under this pillar and pull the archer on top, detonate and then run in for the punch. If it weren't so close to the huntsman, we wouldn't have to do this. The Dreamer, I place a trap just under the top step here, aggro it from around about here, and then hide for cover. The Fell Beast is the most challenging mob here, and I recommend doing this on the test server first. You don't have to, but you can trigger a trapped pouch first to begin the bandy timer early. Hug this wall and bait his AoE ability, then move to the far corner. He won't come all the way, so you need to step back towards him, get that first punch, then trap. From here it's easy. We have activated the 3 points of defense that I talked about. From here, attack the Astral. Wait till he gets to about here, and then run in for the one punch, one trap combo. Next, I place a trap on this tile. Pull the purple Booger Alien Dreamer. and then hide in the hole. Charge this next floating astral jellyfish, and everything from here is the same. You can rope to this flying purple people eater. Remember to use Bepeth's item recycler script. This will basically recycle all the items in your bag, it'll consume the essence, and then put the materials on the ground. Here, it's important to remain calm as a Hindu cow. And that's basically it. I will leave out the same way I entered and just run rope the whole way back to the gate. I'll leave the video here as I don't want it to get too long. If I have left anything out or you have any questions or even tips, please let me know in the comments section. And once again, Antoine, thank you so much for showing me this build. You are a true Giga Chad, bro. I will catch you guys later. See you on the next one.